you're in tune to the Ken Behrens Show. He paid me to say that.
I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my loved one, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me.
Gee, that's a pretty tune. Patti Page, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. You know, it's not often a song gets so popular that people start making parodies of it, but that's what happened with that one. Do you remember the Spike Jones version?
Yes, I do. There was another country version of the two guys that also did Doggy in the Window, yeah.
That goes back a few years.
Yes, it does.
I had Stan Freberg on earlier this week, and he did parodies of songs.
Yes.
And so did Spike Jones, of course. And I guess over the years, Stan worked with some of the people like George Rock and people like that who were working with Spike. That's a beautiful song. Was that, that was you really singing with yourself, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was two voices.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, originally, I was the first one to do the two-voice thing. That was back in 1948, the same year that Les Paul came out instrumentally with, you know, two...
I was going to say, Les Paul is noted for his wonderfully talented guitar.
Uh-huh. And
work.
Then Mary, too, later than that, you know.
Yeah, and they would do what they call, I guess it's called overdubbing, isn't it?
That's right.
And now they do it a lot. It's pretty common. But back then it was something new, and it was probably more difficult to do then.
Well, it was because we were doing it on acetate, which, you know, you lose so much. That was before tape, so you lose so much presence.
You mean it was done on a transcription type of thing?
Uh-huh.
So, oh, it went right to disc.
Oh, yes.
Ha.
And so naturally you lost an awful lot. And then wire was there at the same time. I sound like in the olden, really olden days.
Now, I've seen wire recorders, but I didn't think they ever used them commercially. Did they really do that?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
And then they would put them on the acetate disc. But the original ones of most of the ones that I did in the 50s were done on acetate.
Mm-hmm. I have to tell you, our record's getting kind of old. I hope they release some of these in CDs. Are they going to?
Have that in CD. Yes, it is.
Tennessee Waltz, which was a big million seller in 1950. And to sell a million records back in 50, it took some doings.
Took some doing, is right.
You're going to be in town to sing in person, and I know a lot of people are looking forward to that.
I hope. I really do. It's been a long time since I've been to that area.
Central Illinois, Patti Page at ISU's Brayton Auditorium on March 10th, if my calendar's right.
Huh? You are right. At 8 o'clock, we do a show.
And you're going to be doing a lot of your favorites.
Huh? I do all of those, and we do, well, some of the things from the albums that some of the fans will remember, hopefully.
I was just looking at the Billboard Top Pop Singles from 1955 through 86. That's the version I have here. And I'll tell you, there aren't too many people that have a page devoted to them. In fact, you're over a page. You're about a page and a quarter here.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, Patti Page, Let Me Go Lover, Piddly Patter Patter.
Yes.
And what was the real title for Cross of Gold?
Cross of Gold was Croce de Oro.
Ah, sort of a, is that Spanish?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Muchas gracias. Go on with the wedding, Too Young to Go Steady,
uh-huh.
My First Formal Gown. The ones they have in dark print, I guess, are the biggies. Allegheny Moon, of course. And Old Cape Cod.
Cod, right.
Left, Right, Out of Your Heart.
Yes.
And, oh, yeah, somebody asked about this. You did sing the theme from the motion picture Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte.
Right, that was in, yes, 65.
That was a good movie.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, you've done other things. In fact, you've done some acting, as I understand it.
Did three pictures, is all.
Elmer Gantry was one.
Gantry, right. And Boys Night Out, which I had a record of that. And then we did one that was immediately sold to television with the late David Jansen called Gandhi.
Called Gandhi?
Uh-huh, and they play it every Christmas.
That was the one that was out before the big movie, Gandhi.
Oh, no, Dandy with a D.
Oh, Dandy.
Gandhi.
I was going to say, how would you fit into a story like that?
Taken from the comic strip.
You'll lose a lot of weight and then walk around with a robe on. I'm horrible when it comes to accents.
That's funny.
As you can see. Patti Page is on the line. Would you mind visiting with some people today?
At all.
I'll invite you to call in since, what time is it out in California? You have your wits about you. This is early for you, though, isn't it?
Oh, this is 9-something. I've already had my 3-mile walk.
Okay.
And my shower.
You walk 3 miles every day?
I try to, yeah.
I never really thought about it. You know, I've listened to people who have been singers over the years. And, you know, you can point to people like Bing Crosby. I think Bing Crosby sounded as good just before he died as he did in the earlier days. His voice had a rich character to it.
Right.
I don't know if it's because they sing, because they use the vocal cords all the time, and you use your vocal cords, but maybe you just try to stay in shape.
Yes, maybe. I guess that's it.
You physically have to be in good shape to sing, don't you?
Well, I would imagine. I have always had been in, knock wood, pretty good health. So, but I never vocalize or anything. You know, I never do that as far as my voice is concerned. I cough before I go on stage, but clear my throat.
Uh-huh.
But
are you saying you don't practice?
No, I don't.
You don't have to at this point.
Well, I know if I am doing some new material or something, I can practice. But as far as vocalizing, no, it's different than, you know, opera stars and people who have trained voices, because my voice is not trained. It's just there.
It's natural.
Yeah.
I just read Mel Torme's biography, and you talk about people who don't have trained voices. He tried to take piano lessons, and I think, as I recall, his instructor said, "I don't think you should take piano lessons. If you want to be a songwriter, learn about songwriting. Don't let me limit your capabilities."
Oh, I see.
Which, at first he took it to say, "The guy's just being nice to me. He doesn't want to teach me because he thinks I have no talent." But there are a lot of untrained voices in the biz today.
Oh, well, most of the pop singers are untrained, really.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you find your great vocal groups, you know, those are trained voices.
Yeah, when you say now untrained, that means you didn't take formal lessons. Do you read music?
I read music, but I never studied music.
Oh, I see.
In sight, what they call sight reading. And I have, I know the note goes down so far, you know, and up so far.
And you have the ear for it.
And I have relative pitch, which is not perfect pitch. So
my relatives come and pitch a lot of things at me.
I do sing in tune, and that you're born with.
Okay. Patti Page is on the line, and you can be too. 829-2345 or 1-800-322-9377.
McLean County, it's really happened this time. William Fike Jr., owner of Winnie's Menswear, has lost his mind. Starting today, for a limited time only, Winnie's Menswear will pay your tailoring on all suits, sport coats, and slacks purchased. No gimmicks, no false claims. Winnie's is now featuring free tailoring, in addition to the lowest prices in town on top quality menswear. Can you believe it? Free tailoring on every garment in the store? This only proves you can always do better at Winnie's, your higher quality men's discount store located in downtown Bloomington.
When it gets hot, no one keeps your lifestyle cool and economical better than Carrier. Ask Benedict Plumbing and Heating in El Paso for a free estimate on a Carrier air conditioner. Their prices won't get you hot under the collar, and Carrier air conditioners are so efficient your savings go on and on. Carrier, they're not comfortable until you are. In Bloomington, call 827-7444. In El Paso, call 527-2345. For Benedict Plumbing and Heating, your Carrier dealer. Serving this area since 1936.
It's time to discover pork, the other white meat. This Saturday is ISU Pork Industry Day. Area pork producers will be at Cub Foods, Kroger, Eagle, and Jewel food stores passing out health and nutrition information. Listen to WJBC for a chance to win valuable coupons for America's Choice Burgers and also be one of the first 2,500 fans of the ISU Indiana State game and get 50-cent off coupons for sandwiches. Discover pork, the other white meat, during ISU Pork Industry Day this Saturday. Patti Page is on the line, and so are you. You have a question, sir?
Yes, I do. Actually, it's a statement. I wonder if Miss Page was aware that a lot of the GIs coming back from overseas after the Korean War were using her song as an unofficial theme song.
No.
That song that says, "Cross over the bridge and change your reckless way of living."
Oh, yeah.
You're going home.
Oh, that's... I'm glad you told me that. Thank you.
We all used it back in those days. I just wanted to make her cognizant of it, is all.
Thank you.
That's all I have.
Thanks for calling.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
All right. World War II had a lot of help, I suppose, from the entertainment front. There were those canteens that they set up out on the West Coast, right?
Yeah, well, I was in high school in World War II.
You were too young for that.
But he was talking about the Korean War, which was 10 years later, 50.
I'm sorry. I'm talking about all these old records, and I'm really dating you, Patti. I'm sorry.
That's all right. When you're my age, every year counts.
This would have been the Korean War. I was thinking about the Glenn Miller Orchestra and how it really helped boost morale when it went to the places where men were fighting.
And there were some great artists that went over, too. I get confused a lot of times with Janis Paige.
Yeah.
Because they said, we saw you over in such, you know, during World War II. And I said, well, no, I was in high school in Tulsa.
Well, I was, I don't know if this will make you feel younger or what, but I'm of the generation that grew up listening to How Much Is That Doggy in the Window?
Yes.
That was a biggie around our house.
Well, I'm glad. You're probably 3 years old.
Well, it's probably something like that, sure. If I can sell the audience on that, I'd love to be able to do that.
All right.
What's the story behind that song, anyway? That's kind of, if someone looked at that song today, they'd say, this is pretty pretty hokey, isn't it? I mean.
Right. And it wouldn't be a hit today. You know, a lot of things wouldn't be a hit today, I'm sure.
So timing is very important.
Uh-huh. It has to be. And this was taken from an album for a children's album. And we were doing Arfie the Doggy in the Window. And this was one of the songs that Bob Merrill wrote for the album, and he played it for us, and we did not put it in the album. We took it and made a single out of it. So
so it was sold to a younger audience.
Yes, and it's still being played, you know, like certain little ballet classes will have it, you know, as a number that they use.
Mm-hmm.
Hear all the time from different people who were not even connected, you know, as a fan, maybe their grandchildren or something.
Yeah. I was going to say, I hope we do have some hokey song, some hokey songs for kids, if that's what they are, if they're nice, pleasant songs. That one sold a big volume of records, I think a million in 1952, it says here.
My second biggest record, yeah.
Yeah. But nowadays, it would be somebody like Kermit the Frog singing, maybe.
Yes, you're right.
You're on the air with Patti Page. Hello. Going once, twice. Hello. Oops, somebody gave up on me, Patti. You can get in, 829-2345 or 1-800-322-9377. It's not often we get to talk to somebody of your stature. I'm not talking physical now. I'm just saying somebody who's been around for a long time. You're not a flash in the pan. And I think that's the true measure of success.
Well, I've been singing a long time, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think if... And you listen to these songs. I mean, like I just played a little sample of that one. I have just a sample of the one that the gentleman just mentioned, Cross Over the Bridge. Remember this?
If you're a guy who's had a gal in each and every port, and you forget the rules of love that life has always taught, and if you broke as many hearts as ripples in a stream, well, brother, here's the only way that you can be redeemed. Cross over the bridge, cross over the bridge. Change your reckless way of living. Cross over the bridge, leave your fickle past behind you, and true romance will find you. Brother, cross over the bridge.
Boy, that's a good sound. You know, it's rich orchestration.
Huh?
It's beautiful. You're on the air with Patti Page. Good morning.
Good morning, Ken. Hi, Patti.
Morning.
I can remember when I was in high school and my brother was about 8 years older than I, and he was just a brand new state trooper here in Illinois, and he thought Patti Page was absolutely the greatest, and of course, being brother and sister, we like to argue a lot. So I would say, oh, Patti Page, come on, Peggy Lee. And, oh, would he get mad. And my aunt plays piano by ear, and you ask her to play, and the first thing she plays is Tennessee Waltz, and said, no one could sing like Patti Page. I just said thank you.
Is there a sort of a camaraderie among singers? Do you all get along pretty well?
Oh, I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Incidentally,
I'd like to see her, what was her grandmother, who played piano by ear. I'd love to see her do that.
My aunt.
Oh, your aunt.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Most people use their fingers, of course.
Right. Well, she's had both legs amputated, but she can wheel up to the piano with her wheelchair now, and she still plays Tennessee Waltz, first of all.
Shows the importance of music, I think, in all of our lives.
For me, and thank her.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Where were we? Patti Page is on the line. It's 11:21. I have to break for another commercial or two.
Okay.
And we'll be right back.
Okay, so like I have some really, really important news, you know? So I told this radio guy to do a special news bulletin, and he said, can't, doesn't qualify under FCC rules. So I said, oh yeah? This happens to be the biggest news since acrylic nails, Buster. It's Bergner's big event with 20 to 50% savings on all kinds of really, really, really cool stuff, you know? I mean, what could be more important? To which he replies, bowling tips?
It is a big deal. Bergner's big event this Friday and Saturday only, and only at Bergner's.
It's a consolidation sale at Brahms Furs and Fashions. Hi, I'm Jeff Brahms, and I've consolidated all our winter merchandise from our Peoria store to our Bloomington store, and everything must go. Save 60 to 90% on dresses, suits, knits, cloth coats, ultra suedes, and more. Sportswear by Bliley, Dalton, Adolph Schumann, and Marie St. John, with values from $70 to $300, now just $10 to $30. But this is it. This sale ends Saturday at 5 o'clock. Brahms Furs and Fashions in Brantville, Route 150 in Veterans Parkway, Bloomington.
Does your house have the wintertime woes? Boring bedrooms, lifeless living room, classless kitchen.
Let the cottage in Tawanda Plaza turn that house into a home. Warner Wallpaper is up to 30% off. Waverly Special Order Fabrics and Wallpaper up to 25% off. Save an additional 20% on any in-stock fabric with a green tag. Discover the cottage, your complete decorating center, with designers to assist you in Tawanda Plaza, Bloomington.
This is fun talking to you, Patti.
Thank you, Ken.
Good morning. You're on the air. Hello.
I have a question. It seems to me, and this is kind of personal, but didn't you used to have dark hair when you first started out?
Nope. I never had dark hair.
I would swear I saw you playing in Rockford long time ago, right before you hit it real big. Do you remember that?
I remember playing Rockford, but I never had blonde hair. It may not have been...
No, I mean darker hair.
It may not have been bleached or have streaks in it, you know, like I have now, but I always had an ash blonde hair.
It was a little darker than what it is now. Well, anyhow, I saw you then in Rockford.
Yeah, but there is a lot of people ask me about real dark hair because I took over a show in Tulsa called Meet Patti Page, and there was already a girl singer there who was Patti Page, and she had black hair. I mean, you know, brunette.
No, this was you, because it was right before you hit it really big, I think, in Rockford.
I think this lady's a hairdresser.
No, I'm not either, but I knew I had seen her in Rockford, and it was not long before she hit it, you know, her hit record, her first one.
And
really
always ash blonde, but I didn't have any blonde streaks in it. Right?
Okay, we've settled that, I think.
Okay, anyhow, I really enjoyed it, and I remember seeing you in Rockford when you played there. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for calling. Let's talk about your early career, because I don't know a whole lot about that. Did you sing with any of the big bands? I guess that was pretty much the thing people did, like Sinatra for a while, and then you make it on your own as a singer.
That was just before my time.
There again, I'm trying to age you.
It's okay.
I apologize.
No, I left Oklahoma, and I left with a band, but it was a territory band. And that's how I got the job of the manager, road manager of that band, is still my manager and partner. And he took me with the band, and I was with them 6 weeks in Chicago at the Martinique nightclub on the south side of Chicago. We were there 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
From December 9th to the end of December, I guess.
Yeah. And you were oh so young.
Huh?
You were oh so young.
Yes, I was 19 years old.
Then that is young.
Yeah. So
You are from Oklahoma?
I am from Oklahoma.
Well, I have a question for you. Why do they have those signs all over that say, do not drive through the smoke?
What?
What is it, the Oklahoma Turnpike or whatever they call that?
Well, I haven't been on that in
You probably fly everywhere, don't you?
You know, Merle Haggard says they don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee.
No, I think they do have a problem with fires or something along the road. Okay. And to drive into the smoke is where the danger comes.
Oh, well, I have not been there in a while, you know, on that particular highway.
Yeah, but I figure if a girl can ask you about hair color, at least I can ask you about driving in your home state.
I haven't done either, right?
Here's another call. Good morning.
Yeah, I'm an Oklahoma kid, too, and you don't drive through the smoke because they have grass fires there.
Oh, that's what it is.
Along the side of the highway, it gets burned out brown, and somebody drops a cigarette. It's just like driving in fog.
Okay, so that's a warning, Patty.
Yeah, I will. Thank you.
And I remember hearing stories from my aunt, Virginia Wolf, back when you were just starting. She claims to have accompanied you a couple of times. She was real proud of that all her life.
Well, great. That name is very familiar, and it could very well be true.
Okay. Patty's not going to deny anything today, are you?
No, well.
Except other than she didn't have darker hair.
Thank you. Bye.
Thanks for calling. It's 11:26. I've heard, now if you get a big hit, everybody jumps on it, don't they? I mean, I think that's still, well, maybe it's not as true anymore. Maybe Steve and Edie would jump on it or somebody like that.
No, they used to cover them all the time.
Yeah, and I can remember hearing Dennis Day sing on the Jack Benny Show a portion of this song.
My cradle was the river, my school a riverboat. My teacher was a gambler, the slickest one afloat. My teacher was a gambler, the slickest one afloat. He taught me not to gamble on a petticoat. Oh, I was born to wonder, I was born to roam, and Mr. Mississippi made me feel at home. Oh, I was born to wonder, I was born to roam, and Mr. Mississippi made me feel at home. Oh, darn.
I don't have time to play the whole thing, but I like that song.
Good.
Yeah. Is there a history behind that, or where did that come from? Seems like it's almost out of left field.
Well, I don't really know where it came from.
You had a big hit on it, though, didn't you?
Yes, that was over a million seller for me. That's one of my million sellers. In fact, I have 15 of them.
Uh-huh. You could see where somebody like almost a Phil Harris or a Dennis Day or somebody could really latch onto that and have fun with it.
You're right. But I believe, you know, we used to have different days for songwriters and publishers to bring songs in. And that was probably one of the ones that Mercury picked out and with Jack, because they always work together.
Mm-hmm.
And I did what I was told to do.
Pick it out with Jack, you say?
Yeah, Jack was the man that I told you about that was the road manager for the band that I went with.
I got it.
In Tulsa.
I got it. I'll tell you, there aren't too many people, but when they say the golden hits of Patti Page, they really mean it on this old album. There are just so many.
Yes, I was very fortunate.
Tennessee Waltz, Changing Partners, Cross Over the Bridge, Old Cape Cod, Mockingbird Hill, Doggy in the Window, Detour, Why Don't You Believe Me, Allegheny Moon, With My Eyes Wide Open, I'm Dreaming, and I Went to Your Wedding. Are you going to be singing all those songs?
I sure will.
Plus some new ones, too?
Well, there aren't, they aren't new, because I don't do too many of the top 40.
Yeah, but really, that is something, when you are so popular and have made so many big hits, if you went entirely in a new direction, as some people have tried to do, sometimes the audience walks away a little disappointed. They say, well, gee, I didn't hear them sing the song I wanted them to hear, you know, to hear them sing.
Well, I do a medley at the end of the show of about 12 or 13 of those songs. I do Tennessee Waltz as a separate song. But other than that, we do a Duke Ellington medley. We do some country stuff. It's a potpourri of a lot of different standards.
And you are going to be backed up, as I understand it, by a full orchestra.
Uh-huh. Yes, we have a big band.
So it's going to be a nice evening. This has been most fun. I wish time didn't fly by so quickly, Patty.
Thank you, Ken. I enjoyed talking to you.
Patty Page at ISU, March 10th. That's a Friday night, is it not? Yeah, Friday night.
Uh-huh.
Tickets are available, but I wouldn't fool around too long. I think I'd go ahead and get them and make sure you're in the audience for what should be just a really enjoyable. And can I use the word nostalgic?
Yes, you can.
Nostalgic evening with somebody who's not as old as I made her out to be.
I'm there, Ken.
Okay. Thank you, Patty.
Thank you, Ken.
Bye-bye.
How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the waggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy is for sale. I must take
a trip to California and leave my poor sweetheart alone. If he has a dog, he won't be lonesome, and the doggy will have a good home. How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the waggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy is for sale. I read in the papers there are robbers.
Oh, oh!
With flashlights that shine in the dark. My love needs a doggie to protect him and scare them away with one bark. I don't want a bunny or a kitty. I don't want a parrot that talks. I don't want a bowl of little fishies. He can't take a goldfish for a walk. How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the waggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy for sale.